Hey, Kev.
Hey, Matt. How was work?
I'm a bartender. Any night no one throws up, I'm happy.
Hey, Matt, what are the signs a relationship is over?
All my clothes on the front lawn usually does it for me. What, you and Nancy having problems?
Yeah. I think it's time we went our separate ways.
So how are you going to break up with her?
I don't know. Maybe I'll take her to dinner and break it to her gently.
And embarrass her in a restaurant? Oh, Kev, you're lucky I'm here. Come on. Now, there are lots of ways to do this, but my personal favorite is the drop and run.
Oh, you've titled them.
Only the top 10. Now, you take her out for a nice evening. Then when you drop her off, stay in the car, and just as she gets out, say your last words. Oh, by the way, we're through. Hit the gas and go.
Seems a bit extreme, but maybe the restaurant is a bad idea.
Trust me, too many sharp utensils around. Stacy Weinberg. Fondue fork.
I'm amazed you're still alive.
Oh, that's nothing. You should see Janice Thompson's. It's right
here. No, Matt, that's okay. I don't need to.
Mom, I wouldn't have this option if it wasn't for you. This whole thing got me thinking about living, you know? I guess I always thought that should be the easiest thing in the world. Just living your life. But that's really the hardest thing, isn't it? I need you to know something. No one could have done more to save their son than you did. And I just came home to say thanks. And that I love you more than anyone in the world.
Mike gave me this impossible assignment. He wants me to find some cutting-edge writer's intern, and I just don't know where...
Whoa. Back up, rewind. Did you say writer's intern?
Yeah, and get this. This person has to be a journalism major.
I'm a journalism major.
Plus, they have to have some sort of college newspaper experience.
I have some sort of college newspaper experience. Josh, you gotta get me an interview.
I would, but unfortunately, some guy already slipped Mike his girlfriend's name.
Well, that's it? They're not even going to interview anyone else? That hardly seems fair.
It isn't fair. At least not for the other people, because Mike's hiring you!
Oh, my gosh, Josh, this is fantastic! You're the greatest boyfriend in the universe, and I know. I've been out there.
Well, I have to admit, this wasn't a completely selfless act. Having my girlfriend at work means I'll get to do a lot more of this.
Whoa. Back up. Rewind. I don't think anyone at the newspaper should know about us.
Sabrina, Mike already knows we're a couple.
But I don't want anyone else to know. I mean, this is my first newspaper job in the real world. It's important that people see me as a professional, not just the photographer's girlfriend.
Fine. Okay. As far as I'm concerned, we've never met. You're just some anonymous ditzy blonde.
You're the best! Whoa.
Ronnie, I got that thing you wanted.
Oh, great. Come in. Honey, that's no way to handle a woman.
Sorry. It's a little awkward to carry.
Try having two.
Oh, I have from time to time. I mean, of course I haven't. I was just trying to impress you, which, of course, I haven't. So, I'm gonna go get some fresh air. Okay, you want some? I'm just gonna go.
Jeremy, could you please come into my office for a minute?
Yeah, sure.
I overheard you asking Josh about dating in the office.
Oh, man.
Sit down, please. First of all, don't be embarrassed. I am truly flattered. But, you know, you and I both know that you are a little too young for me.
Oh, no. I have absolutely no interest in you.
Well, thank you for making it clear.
In fact, you sort of remind me of my mom.
I get it, Jeremy.
Albatross?
Yeah.
Robert March, who the hell are you?
Gee, Chuck.
Geek Chuck? What are you, a native or something?
No, it's just Chuck.
Hey, Johnstone, I'm surprised to see you here after the old bowsprit affair.
Yeah, well, I'm back for some more.
Listen to this, man. Romeo here was going at it with some local girl up in the jib sheet, right?
After the deed was done.
Whoa, whoa, hey, he says they did the deed.
Trust me, we did the deed.
All right, man, after the alleged deed was done, they fell asleep. Mr. McCrae walks on deck, and here's Casanova sawing logs. He calls the whole crew on deck. Up goes the jib, and out roll Tato and the girl, naked as goddamn Adam and Eve, man, I swear. Whoa, here we are, guys. Home sweet hell on water.
Oh, look at you. What happened?
Frank, he trashed the place.
You okay?
Yeah, he came by for his money. I told him last week he'd have it today.
You didn't have any of it?
He wanted all of it. Oh, what the hell am I gonna do? Where am I gonna get $2,000 overnight?
$2,000? How'd you get down so low?
I was trying to wipe out the debt. I kept going for double and nothing. Stupid. He's coming back tomorrow, Danny. He said he's gonna kill me.
You gotta get out of here. Go somewhere.
Where am I gonna go? I'm broke.
Can't your parents help you out?
No, please. They cut me off 6 months ago. No. You have to help me.
So your card's gotta be worth a lot.
No, that would take days for the check to clear. I need the money now.
Well, sell something else.
Like what? I mean, look at this place. There's nothing left. No, no, you have to help me get the money.
From where?
Your savings bonds. Your mother.
No, I can't take that kind of money. I can't risk it.
Listen to me. I will sell the car. Just get me the money until the check clears, then I'll pay you back. I promise.
Come on, Marshall. I can't do that.
Please, Dana, I'm begging you. This guy is gonna kill me. All right, look at me. He's crazy. You have to help me, please.